Them one more time. I'm gonna tell somebody next to you to turn around. Everybody, real fast. Turn with me to 2 Timothy, the 2nd chapter. Even under the God who is the head of my life tonight, Chief Apostle, Chief Apostle, Dr. Will Rich and her Lord Jr. Clap your hands for my little one more time. Hallelujah. To our permission, our Caldwell, to our Apostle Adams, to our Prophetess Fedrica, to our First Lady Joanna, Lord, to everyone in the household of faith, we thank God for all these mighty speakers. Praise God. 2 Timothy, the 2nd chapter. Starting at the 11th verse, declares, here is a trustworthy saying. If we die with him, we also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we disown him, he will disown us. Verse 13 declares, if we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot disown himself. I would like to preach from the subject for just a few moments. He remains faithful. Yeah. Tell somebody he remains faithful. People of God, here we are in a text that might seem confusing to some. Understand this, in this day and time, we have found people of God to be unfaithful. Whether it's being unfaithful to the church, being unfaithful in a relationship, yet people pretend to be unfaithful. They don't come to church like they used to. They don't pray like they used to. They don't seek God like they used to. People of God got it mixed up because they come to church with all the wrong reasons. They come to church for all the wrong reasons. They come to church to see what you have on, or to see if the praise is going to be in the house on that night. But the thing is, we need to come to church with expectancy in our heart. But the people of God have lost faith in God. People in the church have lost belief in God. We have came to a point where we believe, we say we believe God, but we don't trust him. And I found it interesting that how can you say you believe someone and you don't trust them? We have all been in a place of disbelief. We have all been in a place where we feel like God is not answering our prayer. We have all been in a place where we feel like God is not there anymore. But I've learned that all I need to do is look up to the hills from which cometh my help, because all of my help cometh from the Lord. The thing is, we have faith in a whole lot of things, but we cannot have faith in God. But I understood in the word of God declares, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. This assurance is based on the belief in the resurrection. It is not based on something we make up in our minds, but faith is an act of trusting God. If we believe something enough, it leads to an action. I understood this time and time again that people put faith in a whole lot of things, and what you have faith in is what you put action in. But the thing is, we don't put no action when it comes down to God. We come to church and we sit down and we look like the preacher got four heads. We come to church and we sit down and we don't say nothing. We come to church and we just sit there and act like we sucking on a sour lemon and looking at people like they crazy. But I came to a place in God where I found out that every time I come into the house of God, I come giving God glory. Moving on swiftly, people of God. Hebrews 11 chapter, going to the 7th verse, understand this. It was a man named Noah, and Noah built this ark. Now the thing is, understanding, if God told you to do something outrageous, if God told you to do something that might not seem similar to what you usually do, God usually tells us something that we may look at God and ask God, what do you mean? Isn't it really possible? But with God, all things are possible. But Noah built this ark based on faith. He built this ark not knowing what it was going to be used for, per se, but not knowing what all the details were. But God told him to build it, and he built it. Noah knew, or he trusted that God night and he remains faithful. The thing is, people of God, when we have all been in a place that we have not been faithful of God, been faithful to God, he has always been faithful to us. The thing is, people of God, we all turned our backs on God at one time or another, but he has never turned his back on us. And the thing is that I understood, and the song declares that, don't give up on God because he won't give up on you. The Bible does declare that he will never leave us nor forsake us, but he will be with us even into the ends of the world. I wish I had a church that talked back to me tonight. Faithfulness is staying true to someone or something, being trustworthy, being someone who can be counted on. Do you find it funny how you can't count on church folk no more? Have you found it interesting that the same place that you come to feel safe and the same place that you come to find comfort and you can't trust none of the ones in the church? We have all been in a place and time where we feel like everybody we come across can't be trusted. Why the Greek word for faithfulness is translated as faith or trusting and believing God. In this context, we have to understand that faith is faith. And the thing is, faith without works is dead. And we have all been in a place where we have not been able to work our faith. We have all been in a place where we had dead faith. And the thing is, people of God, that when we come into the house of God, we need to believe that God is going to heal us or God is going to deliver us out of our problem.
Yeah.
We all should have faith. We should have faith. Faith in God. We should have faith in God that he will bring us out of this situation. People of God, and I'm getting ready to close now. We will have steady faith, one that is not shaken by every bad thing that happens to us. People of God, we have all been through bad times. Our money might be a little funny and our change might be strange and our credit just might not get it, but I came to the place where I always have faith in God. And if you understood this, people of God, we have all come to a place where we might feel like things don't work out the way they seem. Mama might be sick in a hospital, and we don't know what's going to happen. The doctors tell us to prepare for her funeral, but we believe God. And the thing is, people of God, even when we lost faith in our pastor, even when we lost faith in the first lady, I believe we never should lose faith in God. Because the thing is, people of God, that even though God has been there all the time, we might feel like he wasn't there at all. But I want to tell you a little story about a little girl who declared that she was walking on the sand with the Lord. And that the thing is, people of God, while she was walking with God, she realized that through the worst times of her life, that there was only one set of footprints in the sand. But I come to tell somebody that when God, she sat down and asked God, that God, why during the trying times of my life, I feel like there's only one footprint in the sand. And the Lord declared to her and said to her that when you only seen one set of footprints is when I carried you. People of God, I come to tell somebody that even when it feels like it's all, even when it feels like there ain't no end, the Lord is always going to be right there. And I come to tell about four of y'all that get excited. If you remain faithful to him, he will remain faithful to you. So good evening, St. James. God be right there. Church, say amen. Say amen again.
Amen.
One more time for the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We praise God for that.